like this. Ready? Shema Israel. Repeat after me.
Shema Israel.
Adonai Eloheinu. Adonai Echad.
Adonai Echad.
Ve'ahavta.
Et
Adonai. So the gates were also tell the world that something special happened here. Now they think that these standing stones go like maybe 30, 40 feet even further into the ground. And archaeologists don't know why these are here. They don't know what they stand for. But we do know that this was a practice that they did in each in the biblical time, would put up standing stones. Does anybody have verses that say G and SS? Today to the Shephela, up to the Judean mountains, to Jerusalem, over the mountains, into the Judean desert, and here we are at the Rift Valley. Okay? So we went from about 3,000 feet at the top of the mountains, and we will be sleeping by the Dead Sea tonight, and that'll be 400 feet below sea level. Okay? This is the lowest place on earth.
Thank you.
Look at the deer now. I will give you feet like the deer. Pretty cool, huh? Okay, here's another picture. Here's another different picture. In the water. Thank you. multiple reasons why it's considered the Dead Sea. But one of those reasons is because water comes from the Sea of Galilee all the way down the Jordan River and into the northern part of this. This is the place where the Jews that were left over, that had been pushed all the way down south here, where they made their last stand. This is a kanav, this is the tzitzit, and they would put it on the corner of their kanavs. Okay? Now, this is also known as the prayer closet, because they would take these shawls in worship, and they would put them on their heads, and they would wear them like this so that they weren't distracted. So when Jesus says, pray in your closet, I wonder if it wasn't necessarily go find a closet to sit in and pray in, or if it was, you know, go to find some place that you're not distracted.
Life is not so easy as a Christian standing stone. It's a barren wilderness. We can't make it on our own. But the waters of En-Gedi are fresh and flow with life. So find the Lord in prayer, quench your thirst and end your strife. Oh, En-Gedi, taking refuge in the Lord. En-Gedi, let the peace of God reward. Drinking living water and resting in the shade, finding all the comfort to never be afraid. Oh, En-Gedi, in a quiet peace with God.
You can hear it in the word, right?
Haggah!
God says if you want to be this, you need to haggah this. Now the picture is, I always thought meditation was, right? You just sit there and wait until God's word like hits you like a ton of bricks. But that's not the picture. The picture is of a lion who stalks its prey, finds it, searches for it, captures it, tears it apart. And the growl is when they ingest it. And have you heard that before, where the lions just are enjoying what they've ingested? Can I have this word? That's what it means to meditate on God's word.